Dispatch to Unit 1. The fire has spread to the roof of the house as well as an adjoining room. Backdraft potential in the area. Use extreme caution. A secondary unit is on site, providing water coverage for the burning roof. Evacuation status of the house still unknown. Dispatch to Unit 1. Ladder truck is on scene and has assumed safety. Dispatch to Unit 1. Park in front of the building and begin line establishment.
Unit 1 to dispatch. Copy that. Parking in front.
Someone's trapped in the bedroom! Get that person out of there!
Take this Callaghan.
Thanks. We'll take it from here. You can get back to putting out fires and safety.
Thanks for getting me out of here.
Thank you.
This training exercise will get you familiar with using forcible entry tools on doors and walls. Walk forward and open the door. The next door is locked. Grab the crowbar off the bench and walk towards the door. Then, break it open. Good work. Now place the crowbar on the ground in the glowing box. Grab the Halligan tool, walk towards the door, and break it open. Nicely done. Place the Halligan tool on the ground in the box. Grab the demo hog off the bench, walk towards the door, and bust it open. Grab the axe and walk towards the door. Swing at it and smash it open. When there's no available door, create your own. You can break through some walls using any forcible entry tool. Look for the cracks in the wall and break through it with your axe. Examine the wall for cracks and break through with your axe. This training will familiarize you with using forcible entry tools on windows to enter and exit rooms and buildings. Now, grab either tool on the bench, walk over to the window, and smash it open. Okay, now climb through the window into the next area. Job done. Now climb through the window into the... This exercise will familiarize you with using power saws to cut through locks to open doors and vents. Okay, pick up the circular saw from the ground. Good. Now use the saw to cut the lock on the vent ahead. You have to be careful, so aim for the indicated target. Nice. Once more, pick up the saw from the ground. Now, walk over to the garage and use the saw to cut the locks on the door. Cut both locks to open the door. Job complete. This training exercise will familiarize you with using ladders. To use a ladder, you must first attach to it. Walk over to the indicated spot and connect yourself to the ladder. Okay, now climb the ladder by pressing forward. Okay, now reconnect yourself to the ladder and climb back down to the ground. Good. Connect to the new ladder beside you. Now, climb up. Good. Now. Okay. Now climb back down and we'll continue. Job done. With this training exercise, we'll familiarize you with how quickly fire can spread. Okay, stay where you are and just watch the fire spread. Notice how fast it jumps from object to object. Now, grab a hose and put out the fire. Spray water by using the indicated button. Job done. All right, once again, just watch the fire spread. Okay, you know the drill. Grab a hose and put out the fire. Spray water by using the indicated button. Good work. Now, grab a hose and try to put out both grease fires. Water doesn't help, does it? In fact, it makes it worse. Water and grease fire don't mix. To fight grease and chemical fire, you'll need to use a portable CO2 extinguisher. Grab an extinguisher and aim it at the base of both fires. Sweep the extinguisher side to side on the flame to make sure you put it out. Good work. When out on calls, look for different types of flames so you can be ready for any grease or chemical fires you run into. This training exercise will familiarize you with how to effectively fight a fire using the hose aiming interface. All right, grab a fire hose and enter the door in front of you. Quench that fire with the attachment. Look at the on-screen indicators in proximity to where the water hits the flame and learn how they can help you to assess the firefighting progress. Don't hesitate to change your position to get a better aim. This helps you quench the fire as quickly as possible. Okay, fire's out. Take your attack hose into the next room. Good. Fire's out. You may have noticed the sparks coming from the lamp on the table. These sparks can and will reignite the fires after you've put them out. This can create a dangerous situation of potential fires in areas you thought were safe. America, since electricity will restart the fire multiple times, the best way to deal with electrical fires is to cut the main power by finding and using the fuse box. So, instead of wasting water on an electrical fire, walk over to the fuse box on the wall and turn off the electrical fire. Okay, fire's out. Now walk into the next room. All All right, since you already know how to deal with grease fires, grab an extinguisher and put those fires out. You'll notice that both the attack hose and the CO2 extinguisher use the same interface to help you put out fires as efficiently as possible. Okay, fire's out. Job done. This exercise will get you up to speed on smoke, how it affects your vision, and how to effectively clear it. Smoke is dangerous and can seriously harm you, which is why you'll always be equipped with an SCBA system to ensure you can breathe in any situation. When going into a smoke-filled area, be sure to use your helmet-mounted flashlight. It'll really make a difference. Turn it on now before entering the building. Smoke rises. Getting below the neutral plane of the smoke keeps you in. Go ahead and open all the windows in this room. Now, open the door and enter the next area. It's full of smoke. Stay crouched so you have the maximum. Now, open the door and enter the next area. Okay, we're going to take a different approach for this room. A smashed window is just as effective as an open window. If you need to vent smoke but run into a locked window, don't let that stop you. Grab a tool off the bench and smash both windows. Nice work. The smoke will clear out in no time. In this next phase, we'll take a slightly different approach. If you still have the forcible entry tool, use it to smash open one or both of the windows. Good. Now enter the building by climbing through the window. It's smoky in here too. Remember to stay crouched to improve your visibility as the smoke clears from the window you just smashed. Now, open the door and enter the next room. Okay, you know the drill. Stay low and open the. Now we're going to learn about one of the most dangerous situations you'll ever encounter, a backdraft. Backdrafts often surprise even experienced firefighters. Backdrafts occur when the oxygen within a room has been used up, and then more oxygen is rapidly reintroduced into the area. This is caused by opening a door or window in an oxygen-depleted environment. When backdrafts occur, fire explodes out of the door or window and can become a fast-moving fireball, causing damage to anything in its path, and can even badly injure you. Okay, enough talk. Now we're going to show you a backdraft event so that you know what to look for in your potential backdraft situation. First, walk over to the window on the left and look into the room. You'll notice that the room is full of smoke, but there are no visible signs of flames. This indicates that the room is above its upper flammability limit. This means that the gas or vapor in the air is capable of producing a flash fire. Just needs an ignition source, oxygen. Okay, look at the locked door on the left. Notice that the door is different than other doors and has signs of a potential backdraft. In addition to the room being full of smoke with no visible flames, there's also smoke at the base of a door along with a pulsing sound. Do you hear it? It's a low thud. This sound seems like it's repeating because the room's trying to suck air into it. It needs oxygen to reignite the fires within.
Okay, the door's unlocked.
Open the door, but immediately back away from it to avoid the blast from the back. Okay, notice that the area opposite the door was caught in the fireball and is now on fire. Put out the flames in this room, then move through the door into the next room and extinguish the fires there. Put out the fires in this room, then go through the door and into the next room to extinguish the fires there. Put out the fires in this room, then go through the door and into the next room to extinguish the fires there. Put out the fires in this room, then go through the door and into the next room to extinguish the fires there.
Good work.
Now notice that the next locked door has signs of a potential backdraft. Do you see the smoke at the base? Do you hear the pulsing sound? Okay, the door's been unlocked. Like last time, open the door, but remember to immediately back away from it to avoid the backdraft. Put out the fires in this room, then move through the door to get to the next room so you can extinguish the fires in there. As I said before, even experienced firefighters can be surprised by backdraft. So pay attention to any closed door that you approach and look for signs of backdraft. It could save your life. This training exercise will familiarize you with setting up attack hoses to fight fires and show you how to connect a fire truck to a hydrant water supply. First, we'll establish a water supply line. This ensures you never run out of water when fighting fires. Now, walk over to the indicated compartment on the truck and grab a supply hose. The supply hose is the yellow one. Okay, now, look directly at the connector on the truck. You'll notice that you first need to remove the cap from the connector, so go ahead and remove the cap. Good. Now, look directly at the connector on the truck and connect the hose couple. Good. Just like the connector on the truck, look directly at the connector on the fire hydrant and remove the cap. Head over to the indicated connector on the other side of the truck and connect the supply line to it. Like before, remove the cap, Okay, now we're going to attach an attack hose to the truck. Attack lines are colored red to indicate they're different from supply lines. Now, go to the back of the truck and grab an attack line. You can also grab one from any of As with the supply line, you'll need to first remove the cap from the truck, unroll the hose, and then connect the hose coupler to the truck. Nice. We're going to need a nozzle for the attack line. The nozzle allows you to increase or stop the flow of water as needed. Now, pick up the coupler from the ground and walk to the back of the truck. Open the lower compartment and swap the hose coupler with the nozzle. Now that you have a nozzle, look directly at the coupler on the ground and attach it to your nozzle. Good work. All right. Started a huge pallet fire. Utilizing the unique interface from previous training, use the attack hose to put out the entire fire. Try to extinguish the fire as quickly as possible, but we're timing it. Lowest time score gets bragging rights. Go! Clock is starting. Put out the fire as quickly as you can. Out. Job done. With this training exercise, you'll give commands to your squad mates. This will allow others to complete tasks for you while you focus on other objectives. Have a look at the upper right corner of your screen. You can see the AI indicator along with the associated shortcut. Point at the circle on the ground and press the shortcut for the AI that you've just seen in the upper right corner. The AI character will now walk to the indicated location.
I'm on it.
Good. Now direct the AI to the second circle, followed by the third.
Yes, sir.
Well done. You've just learned how to give go-to commands. Now, call the AI to your position. To give the command, hold down the AI shortcut key until the status icon in the upper corner changes to the follow symbol. The AI will now follow you. Walk along the waypoints. As you can see, the AI is following you in close proximity as you move around. As you can tell, the AI is very closely following your movements.
I'm on it. Copy that. I'll follow you.
Go ahead and instruct the AI to wait. Hold down the AI shortcut key until the status icon in the upper right. Two victims need help in that building. Your mission? Rescue them. Head through the door and into the building. The door's locked. Instruct your AI to equip a Halligan tool and come to your location.
Yes, sir. Yes, Commander.
All right, you can instruct the AI to open the door for you. AI can interact with all context-sensitive objects like doors, windows, victims, and many others. Your crosshair will change when you aim at objects your AI squadmate can interact with. Press the AI shortcut key. Now, follow the indicated on-screen interaction. The AI squadmate will grab a hose and start combating the fire.
Door is open, boss! Yes, sir. Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander. Okay, boss. I'll put that fire out. Yes, Commander. Okay, boss. I'll put that fire out. Yes, Commander.
Don't forget to get both victims to the paramedics. Use the AI shortcut again while aiming at the victim. While the AI is bringing the victim to safety, they're no longer available for other commands because their main priority is getting the victim to the paramedics. Go ahead and carry the other victim to the paramedics yourself to finish this training mission.
Yes, Commander. I'm on. Okay, boss.
There's another fire in the next room. Command the AI to deal with the fire there, too. Give another go-to command to send the AI into the room with the fire. This training exercise will familiarize you with how to use ladder trucks and aerial arms to attack fires from above and to rescue victims in elevated locations. Before extending the truck's ladder, we must first stabilize it and ensure that the truck will not tip over with the ladder boom extended. Walk over to the indicated control panels and extend all the truck's outrigger arms. While deployed, the outrigger arms simultaneously bypass the vehicle's movable suspension and gives the truck an overall wider stance, making the entire rig more stable. Okay, all the outriggers are extended. Walk over to the indicated area and engage the ladder boom controls. Walk over to the indicated areas and engage the ladder boom controls. Good. The ladder arm offers you 3 degrees of movement: up, down, left, right, and forward, backward. Extending the ladder arm forward and backward effectively lengthens and shortens the length of the ladder. Now, use the indicated controls and move the ladder in the up and down directions. Good. Now, use the indicated control. Excellent. Now, you're going to use the ladder arm and bucket to rescue some victims. Use the ladder arm controls and move the ladder bucket to either indicated area. Wait for the victim to walk to the bucket. You're essentially using the ladder bucket to give them an escape route. So once the victim has reached the bucket, they've moved into the safe zone and are considered safe. The player can exit the bucket by pressing the use key. Exit the bucket and rescue the victim by interacting with them and returning to the bucket. Okay, you've saved one victim. Now position the bucket near the other indicated roof and wait for the victim to reach the bucket. This victim is unconscious, so you'll have to carry them back to the bucket. Up. Press the indicated button now to switch back to controlling the bucket movement to try it out. When you've relocated the bucket to a better location, switch back to controlling the nozzle and extinguish the fires. Fires are out. Job done. Congrats. You've completed the firefighter training course and are ready to handle any situation so you can save as many lives as possible. Feel free to return to the training facility to practice your skills if you need help with the more difficult emergency calls you may encounter. Remember, we train today to be safe tomorrow.
Dispatch to Unit 1, reports indicate the fire has begun to spread. Evacuation status of the house is still unknown.
Unit 1 to dispatch. Copy that.
Thank you. dispatch to Unit 1. Park in front of the building and begin line staffing.
Unit 1 to dispatch. Copy that. Parking in front.
Dispatch to all units. Unit 1 on scene, assuming command. Continue working the fire.
Command, we've got electrical fires being relit by sparks. Find a fuse box and cut the power.
Copy that. I'll do a 360 check. Doing a 360 check. The front door is locked. On a 360 check, there are fires in the front room. On a 360 check, there's a locked door at the rear of the house. Command, I found a survivor. Okay, boss. 360 check complete.
The attack line is ready to go, boss.
Supply lines ready to go, boss.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir.
I'll put that fire out, boss.
Victim is safe, boss.
Yes, Commander.
dispatch to Unit 1. We've got a situation. I'll have to cut your warehouse inspection short.
Unit 1 to dispatch. We are en route to the scene.
Dispatch to Unit 1. Copy that. Acknowledged. Unit 1 en route.
Copy that. I'll do a 360 check. Command, I found a survivor. On a 360 check, we have a survivor in the left room, in the back of the house. There's a stack of wood at the rear to help you gain access through the window.
The attack line is ready to go, boss.
Okay, boss. 360 check complete.
Supply lines ready to go, boss.
with you, boss. Lead the way.
I'm with you, boss. Lead the way.
Acknowledge. I'll follow you.
On a 360 check, the fire's in the front lobby area. It looks like it's spreading upstairs, towards the living room.
Okay, boss. I'll break it open. I'll need to get a tool first.
on it.
Okay, boss. I'll put that fire out.
Thank you.
Check. On a 360 check, we have fires in the central area of the park.
The attack line is ready to go, boss.
Heads up, we've got a burning tree. On a 360 check, we have fires engulfing a bench.
Supply lines ready to go, boss.
I'm on it.
Yes, sir.
Put that fire out, boss.
I'm on it.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir.
I'm on it.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander.
I'm on it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir.
I'm on it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir.
I'm on it.
Yes, Commander. I'll put that fire out, boss.
I'm on it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander.
I'm on it.
I'm on it.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir.
I'm on it.
I'm on it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, Commander.
I'm on it.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Commander.
I'm on it.
Yes, Commander.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, Commander. Yes, Commander. Yes, sir. I'm on it. Yes, Commander. I'm on it. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm on it. I'm on it. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I'm on it. Yes, Commander. Yes, sir. I'm on it. Yes, Commander. Yes, sir. Yes, Commander. I'm on it. Yes, sir. Yes,
Yes, Commander.
to dispatch? Unit 1 approaching C.
Dispatch to Unit 1. The newspaper stand is now fully engulfed.
Back, boss.
Yes, sir.